Rush skeletonweed, scientific name chondrilogensia, is a noxious weed in Montana whose presence is limited to a few areas of the state. It's very important to know how to identify it so it can be controlled before it has a chance to spread farther. Identification is complicated, however, by the native skeleton plant, scientific name ligodesmiagensia, that looks similar to rush skeletonweed and may grow in the same habitats, that being rangelands, pasture, and roadways. Here are some key characteristics to look for to identify rush skeletonweed and distinguish it from native skeleton plant. The leaves at the base of rush skeletonweed grow in a circular fashion called a rosette. As the plant continues growing, it develops a main stem with many branches. The lower 4 to 6 inches of the main stem have stiff hairs that point downward. Native skeleton plant also has a main stem with many branches, but the stem is smooth without the stiff hairs at the base. As the names imply, skeleton weeds lack obvious leaves. The plant simply looks like a skeleton of a plant. This is true of both rush and native species. Both species also have a white, milky sap. Rush skeletonweed is generally taller than native skeleton plant. For example, rush skeletonweed may grow up to 3.5 feet tall, while native skeleton plant is usually 1 to 1.5 feet tall. But don't rely on height alone, as plant height can vary depending on where the plant is growing. The two species are easiest to tell apart by their flowers. Rush skeletonweed has bright yellow flowers. The native has pink to light purple flowers. Another difference is that native skeleton plant sometimes has round galls on the stem. In summary, for rush skeletonweed, look for downwardly bent hairs at the base of the stem and yellow flowers. For the native, look for a smooth stem, pink to purple flowers, and occasionally some galls on the stems. See our MSU Extension Bulletin for more details. For assistance identifying plants, including rush skeletonweed and other noxious weeds, contact your local Extension office, county weed district, or other trusted resource.